God's power changes everything. God's love compels. God loves everyone and His Son changes everything. Yeah, His Son changes everything. God gives friends. God blesses abundantly. God wants everyone to know Jesus. Can you shout Jesus? God delivers. God is a living God. God calls us to more. God calls us to life with Him. God is the beginning and the end. God gives freedom. Extreme life. Extreme life. Leave your mark.
Solid.
Hey kids, last week in the Big God story, we talked about how the Holy Spirit came upon the disciples. Do you remember how they began to speak in foreign languages and how they began to share the good news of Jesus? And all of a sudden, 3,000 people began to follow Jesus that day. The church was alive and it was growing. And the Holy Spirit, when He came, the Bible says, He filled the disciples with power. And last week we talked about how the Holy Spirit changes everything. This week we're going to talk about how God's power changes everything. And we're going to get the story like every week from God's Word, from the Bible. And it's in the New Testament. And right after this happened, when the disciples were filled with power, they began to see things differently. What do I mean by they began to see differently? Well, maybe like before things didn't look quite normal or quite stewed like in this picture. But when the Holy Spirit came, things began to look clear. They began to see clearly. That's what God's power did. You see, God's power also changed everything. They began to see things differently. And so the next couple of days or weeks and months, they began to live differently. With His power, they set out into the world and they began to live a life that was different. Live a life that Jesus had taught them to live. And so in our story today in the New Testament, we see one of the apostles, one of the disciples, Peter, and he's with John, and they're walking to the temple. And as they get to the temple, they see a man laying at the side, a man who had been lame. That meant he couldn't walk even since he was a baby, since his birth. And so they see this man and they have compassion on him. And every day people grab this man from his home and they take him to sit by the temple so that maybe some people have compassion. Maybe some people will give him some money so he has food to eat. Peter and John, they see this man and they walk up to him and approach him. And the man says, "Do you have any money? Do you have any money?" Now Peter, because he's filled with God's power, sees things differently. And rather than just giving money, he says, "Silver and gold I do not have, but what I do have, I give to you. Rise up and walk." I love that. I love the way that Peter responds, and guess what happens? God's power changes everything. The man stands up and he walks away. He's dancing and full of joy. God's power changes everything. You see, in your life and my life, when God's power is at work in us through the ministry of the Holy Spirit, we see things differently. Things should become clear to us. When the power of the Holy Spirit's at work in us, we don't see how big problems are around us. Instead, we see how big and powerful God is, and how He is able to help us in our time of need. And so today, what about you? What pain, what hurt, what problems do you face? Did you know the Holy Spirit can help you? God's power at work in you changes everything. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You that Your power changes everything. We thank You for the Holy Spirit who can lead us and guide us and help us every day. Help us to keep our eyes fixed on You. Amen. Have a great day this week, and I can't wait to see you next week.